The seventh console generation might have started out strong with a superb variety of genres to choose from, but as the years dragged on and the world entered an economic downturn, the variety on display slowly dwindled, until all that was left was either first or third-person shooters, and occasionally Assassin's Creed. One of my all-time favorite franchises, Mass Effect, started the generation out as an ambitious and excellent RPG that just so happened to have third-person combat, and wound up throwing all of the RPG mechanics out the airlock and became a half-ass Gears of War clone by generation's end. The original Dead Space went from a third-person survival horror game in 2008, and by the time the third game rolled around in 2013, it was a co-op action game. But don't think for a second that the creative drought was just a North American phenomenon. Long before the Lehman Bros went under, the Japanese were already having difficulty making HD games at a reasonable cost, let alone making games that appealed to the Western market. Hell, at the time, they couldn't even appeal to their fellow Japanese after everyone and their waifu switched to phone gaming in the late 2000s. By the end of the decade, the signs were clear for many Japanese studios. Either curb development costs or double down and try to break into the mainstream in the West. Many chose the latter. And so it was that Resident Evil became an Army of Two clone, Front Mission went from being excellent turn-based strategy games to becoming a third-person shooter, Castlevania became a cheap God of War knockoff, and Metal Gear Solid stayed a pompous, bloated movie game that confused cutscenes for gameplay. But not all attempts at courting the West resulted in the cheapening of an already existing franchise in order to appeal to the then average American who gave less of a fuck about video games unless its name started with Call and ended with Duty. Enter Platinum Games. Now, Platinum has a rather diehard fanbase of horny weeaboos, whose mouths have been latched to the company's crank ever since Bayonetta pole danced her way into our hearts. Just look at those legs. I've personally found most of Platinum's games to be lackluster to outright bad after the studio's first couple of releases. And the game that I consider more or less the end of Platinum's talent and ambition, more on that later, is also the subject of this video, the often overlooked, high-speed, slow-mo bullet soup simulator that is Vanquish. I'm just going to be blunt. The plot of Vanquish is shit. The only reason Vanquish even has a plot, it seems, is to give some threadbare pretense and excuse to have our hero Sam blast apart Russian robots in space. And if that was the story's only goal, then in that regard, the plot succeeded. But for context, I will elaborate slightly further. In the near future, evil space Russians take over a Russian space colony that just so happens to be a giant fuck-off space microwave gun and use it to marginally improve San Francisco by frying it and everyone dumb enough to still live there to a crisp. The president, man, they really thought Hillary was going to win the next presidential election after Obama, huh?
Absolutely
wrong.
Anyways, knockoff Hillary declares war on space Russia and orders the space marines to seize the space colony slash microwave. DARPA, just like in the Gulf Wars, sees this as an opportune time to test its newest highly experimental tech, namely a rocket-propelled combat suit and its slow-motion abilities. So our hero, Sam, being DARPA's test rat, is shipped off with the Marines to fight for America. Like I said, not exactly deep. But that's okay. Most video games, and especially Japanese ones, aren't exactly known for their literary acumen. Vanquish's strengths lie elsewhere, in something infinitely more important for a video game: gameplay. At a passing glance, Vanquish might seem like any other dime a dozen cover shooter from that generation of gaming. God knows, there is a fuck ton of them. But a wise man once said, the devil is in the details. Or, in this case, the way Vanquish delivers on a sense of speed. At the time of Vanquish's release, most third-person shooters were more or less following the Gears of War school of combat design. Walk into a room, take cover behind any of the myriad chest-high walls, peek out of cover to shoot enemies, or flush them out with grenades. And you only really moved from cover to gain a more advantageous position or when forced. Your best bet for surviving was to take up a decent defensive position and let the enemies break their teeth on your chainsaw bayonet. In Vanquish, the core formula still holds true. Walk into a room with chest-high walls, take cover, shoot enemies. What sets Vanquish apart is its sense of urgency. Even on normal difficulty, you will die in a handful of seconds when exposed to enemy gunfire. Thus, when flushed from cover, which happens often, you will have at best several seconds to locate fresh cover. This is where the game's slow-mo mechanic comes into play. You can rocket from cover to cover, limiting your exposure to rival gunfire, or use it to lay waste to enemies. The brilliance of this mechanic lies in it acting as both your boost gauge and your health. Turning combat into an intense affair of split-second decision-making of when you should boost, shoot, or slow-mo your way across the battlefield, juggling your health, enemy's position, and your own ammo. Should you shoot, or risk it all to save a downed ally, who, upon revival, will drop a random weapon? Throw in the arcade-like scoring system that judges you harshly on factors such as the amount of times you take cover, clear time, enemies defeated, allies lost, and total deaths. And Vanquish comes together as an exhilarating breakneck ride along the borders of victory and defeat, an addictive and tight-controlling deluge of bullets and explosives that penalizes the player for playing like a bitch and cowering behind cover, all while daring them to endlessly retry missions, chasing the ethereal dragon that is shorter and shorter clear times and higher scores. It's masterful work. Platinum managed, by and large, to take what makes no death, no hit speedruns of character action games so appealing, and replicated that feeling with an entirely different set of mechanics. And to me, that is what makes Vanquish Platinum's crowning achievement. There is some pitfalls along the way, to be sure, like the ass-backwards weapon upgrade system, or the lackluster nature of some of the more exotic weapons. But Vanquish is still a great game, one that I replay every so many years, and thanks to its short runtime, you can beat it in a day or two. And if you missed it back on release, I hope you go back and give it a shot, since I feel like Vanquish is often overlooked and forgotten, even by Platinum game fanatics. If you cannot tell by now, I am a firm believer that there is a lot the Western and Eastern schools of video game design can take from each other, and Vanquish is one such example. It is a Japanese take on the third-person shooter genre, but instead of trying to imitate the West beat by beat like so many other Japanese studios at the time, Platinum instead embraced their inner anime-loving samurai and put their own spin on the genre, and it paid off by and large. Not necessarily in temporary sales figures, but in eternal quality. But then again, what do you expect from a game directed by my boy, Shinji Mikami, whose company, Straight Story, developed Vanquish under the Platinum Game brand and also helped out massively with Bayonetta? Straight Story was disbanded after Vanquish's release, and Mikami moved on to go pal the fuck around with Bethesda and make The Evil Within. So maybe that's why I've always felt that after Vanquish, Platinum's quality took a nosedive. You can get Vanquish along with the sexy Bayonetta in a combo pack for both the PS4 and Xbox One. Or, you can go the Master Race route and pick it up on Steam. It's good shit, and comes highly recommended. If the gods of video editing allow it, I should be seeing all of you lovely fucks again next month for the Halloween episode. So, hopefully, I'll see you then. Mwah!